Chidambaram, conference treasurer, Reverend Dr. Paul Raj, and Reverend Jagannathan Pete, O Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I have visited this church other days, not on Sunday, and we thought of coming to you. You look more good on Sundays, and it is good to see you on Sunday. Not only that, it is a renovation time, and that is a very important day. I myself and my wife are present. It's really honor and privilege to be with our own churches, and I feel good when I preach the Word of God. And I'll go to the straight to the Word of God, which was chosen for this morning devotion, Exodus. I speak about the temple, and in the Hebrew for born again life. That means the church are the person who is a temple of God. Though the Nicodemus was one of the Sanhedrin, about 70 judges, he was one of them. In spite of his education, great name, and Jesus informed him, you have to be born again. And that is a very, very important. If you turn to Isaiah chapter 66, verse 1 says, the Lord says, heaven is my throne and earth is my foot. What kind of a house then could you build for me? What kind of place for me to live in? God is explaining, the heaven is my throne. Heaven is his throne and earth is my foot. What kind of church? If you think, if I think about the church, such a big God and holy God, and what we prepare for our God, that means God wants the real hearts, holy people, and also the faithful believers. And number one, the tent of the Lord's presence and the temple. The tent, as I already have said, Exodus 33, 7 to 11. Whenever the people of Israel set up a camp, we can see whenever they gather together, and a camp, and Moses would take the sacred tent and put it up some distance outside the camp. It was called the tent of the Lord's presence. The tent of the Lord's presence. Whenever they gather, wherever they set apart, and even the church in the New Testament, the word in the Greek ekklesia is called. Ekklesia means called out people, separated people, and set apart. We are all set apart. That means unless until you believe Jesus as the personal Savior, agree and accept him, then you are not set apart. You are not temple of God. And that is the reason Old Testament ecclesia is called out people. And tent is a pillar. Cloud will come down. And he's talking in the 33rd, cloud will come down. And when we worship, when we praise God, and God is going to come down to dwell in the church. That kind of temple it should be. That kind of church it should be. And we also have to praise God that we may receive the presence of God. Are you feeling the presence of God? And when you come here, think about your own things, that means you will not feel the presence of God. If you have your own mind set up, you will not have the presence of God. When we come here, and the pillar of cloud will come down and stay at the door of the tent. Door of the tent. And in the New Testament, Jesus says, I will knock the door, whoever opens, I will enter into the room. That is what in the even the same continuous understanding is there. He's continued his presence. He knocks the door. He knocks the heart. See, when Lydia was listening to the word of God, God opened her heart. So, is God is opening your heart? Is God is entering into your heart? And that is what in Exodus Moses is expressing when he went to the tent and he set apart the tent. He also uses here the sacred tent. Tent also be used for other things, another games, another drinking place, and many other unwanted things also. But here the word sacred tent. And that is what the temple and the tent of the Lord's presence is that. And also the door of the tent, and the Lord which spoke would speak to Moses from the cloud face to face. Face to face. As we read Bible, when we read Bible, God is speaking through Bible. But Moses here, he went there to the presence of God. In those days, so blessed, Moses was speaking to God face to face. Because the cloud came down and dwelled in that tent. The presence of God is there. It is not like anything idol which we keep in the tent and worship. Here our God is a living God. Our God is a speaking God. Our God is face to face. That means his presence was speaking to Moses. And is God speaking to you this morning? When you think about God, when you sing the word of God, and when you sing the song, through the word, in many things, God will speak to us. And that is a tent means in the presence of God. And also just as a man speaks with a friend. And that is what the privilege was completely different. Those people were very holy. And Abraham was walking with God. And he called him as a friend of God. Enoch was all the time walking with God. He lived, but he did not die. Without death, he was taken away from the earth. And that is the reason the heart at the temple of God eternal. And if you turn to the 1 Kings chapter 5 and verse 5, speak to us. The Lord promised to my father David, your son, whom I will make king after you, will build a temple for me, and now decided to build the temple for the worship of the Lord my God. When King Solomon finished all the work of the temple, he placed all things that his father David had dedicated to the Lord. Dedicated to the Lord. Here to worship. That means I would like to tell you the word acts. Acts means in the Bible, no, I'm not talking about that acts. Luke and say afterwards which was written by the Dr. Luke. Not that Acts. Acts means adoration. When you come to the church, adoration is very, very important. That is what praise and worship. We devote ourselves. Sometimes when I was in the hostel, that means silent prayer. Come into my heart and come into my heart. There was a song. In the beginning, they sing that when all will close their... They used to tell in the hostel, let us close our eyes. Let us invite our God, our Jesus, into our hearts. When you come, that adoration, that means when you come to the church, adoration, you have to have adoration. Praise God. And the confession. After the adoration, when you come to the church, worship means first is adoration and the confession. We have to remove our sins, remove our differences, redeem from the sin. The confession, you may have differences, you may have many things. If you don't have a pastoral heart, if you don't have a believer's heart, if you don't have a forgiving heart, then you are not a Christian. And that is how God taught us Lord's Prayer. Is it not? Every day we say the Lord's Prayer also. That is a confession is important. When we close our eyes, when we have come to the renovated church, renew yourself, renew your heart, revive, renew, repent. All these kind of words that Jesus spoke to us, God spoke to us here, and that the confession. And the third thing, ACT. T means thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. And did you say all the time? And many people died because of the corona. Yeah? You are very careful. Even pastors are carefully wearing their masks. We are alive because we were careful and doing something. You are all doing, and today you are alive. I am alive. I am speaking to you. See, that goodness is in us. Nothing but the grace of God on us. Crores of people died all over the world. Crores, not lakhs. Crores of people died. We are not counted in that crores. And God made us alive. It is not for goodness. It is not for our richness. It is not because of our good health. But all ages, from child to the elderly people, we are all alive. Thank God. We really thank God. Thanksgiving is for what? When people get something, a big amount, then only they would like to give thanks. But I would say, I am alive today. I want to give thanks to God. I am speaking. Even if you are alive, many people may not speak and may not move, paralyzed, and you will be at the beds. We are better than those people. Thanksgiving, adoration, confession, thanksgiving. The last one is supplication. And we sacrifice. We commit ourselves to God. If this is not there in everyday worship, there is no renovation. There is no revival. Revival comes from individual. Then it will spread to the groups. So we first, all this Annal, Memorial, Methodist Church, everyone should have a revival in their life. Renovated. When the renovated church, we all will come together, feel happy to sit in the renovated church. In the same way, when you would like to sit in the renovated church and Jesus would like to come, renewed heart. And he told very openly to Nicodemus, he told very openly to Samaritan woman, he told the woman, Maria, and also these all people have expressed and boldly they have given witnesses. And what the Samaritan woman said, come and see the person who revealed everything what I have done. And he brought many people to Jesus because he revealed what she has done. That means all iniquities were removed from her heart. Renovation of the temple, I am not talking about the repairs. I am talking about temple. We are the temple. Our bodies are temple of God. And if you turn to the 1 Kings 8, 1 to 13, there it says, King Solomon prayed that now I have built a majestic temple for a place for you to live. And he's expressing, and you know, why every year lakhs of people are going and visiting Israel. And people feel when they go there, we have visited Lord's temple. Lord is everywhere, understanding. But we call it, and we in Hyderabad they will say, we are going to Holy Land. I don't know what year they will say same thing. Yeah, Parishuddha Nagarama. And so you all will go the holy place. How God has given entire world that is a holy place. Because Solomon is saying that I have built a majestic temple for you, a place for you to live. Such a way he built that church. And the same way we have to build our own bodies. And that is what Holy Land, whether you go to Holy Land are not different, but only thing is your body is holy. You and I and do. That is the reason the temple of God. What is the temple of God? It's the Lord's presence. Second one is the temple of dedication prayer. The temple of dedication. So this is what we have come here, and we would like to invite Bishop that we should have a prayer and begin this renovation. In the same way, if you turn to the 1 Kings 8, 22 to 28, then in the presence of the people, Solomon went and stood in front of the altar where he raised his arms and prayed, Lord my God, I am your servant. Listen to my prayer and grant the request of make to you today 10 petitions. And we also see that he has making 10 petitions. And he stretched his arms. When you come, you stretch your arms and pray and devote yourself in prayer. Definitely there will be change. There will be, say, come before the altar. You humble yourself. And even Chronicles 7:14 also speaks about if you humble yourselves and pray, so that God is going to heal your nation. And that is what the Lord is speaking here. Raised his arms and prayed. Listen to my prayer. Have you ever prayed, Lord, hear our prayers. Lord, hear me, Lord. When God is not hearing, when God is not doing anything, we think that and we go and cry. Some people are not able to pass even 5 years, 6 years. They have to go and cry. Some people are not getting children. And when they go and cry, Lord, are you not hearing my prayer? And Hannah prayed like that. Her womb was opened and he gave a son, that Samuel. And Samuel became a great man and he blessed the Jesus family. He blessed the Jesus that whom the heredity was come, you know. That is what he blessed. And 10 petitions only, what he prayed I will give you. Number one is 1 Kings 8:29. Watch over the temple day and night. What he prayed, he also had experience of building the temple. Watch over the temple, Pastor, on Sunday only. No, your pastor is no, Bishop is said. Here the first prayer is, if you, and where I worked in Millennium Church, every day church will be open. And there is an upper room. And I used to go to upper room. Every morning, my morning devotion was in upper room and prayer. The church was opened every day. The church grew up in such a way that has become source of blessing to many people. And I worked for 11 years in that church. And the church people said, till you retire, Bishop, Pastor, you should be here only. And I felt, we both felt very happy. Because presence of God, in the here, the King Solomon is praying, watch over the temple day and night. And very soon we will go. Second one is, hear my prayers and the prayers of your people. And he is also asking, hear my prayers and hear prayers of people. Congregation also will come. Pastor saying, Pastor, Lord, hear my prayers. Hear my congregation prayers. What a good and a wonderful man, King Solomon. A temple, why the temple was built. His presence and also petitions. They hear our prayer. And if we see the second and third one, 1 Kings 8:31 to 32. When a person is accused of wronging another, see what is, you know, there will be differences between two persons. So you have to pray. Have you prayed for only friends, or how many of you have prayed for enemies? I don't think they will pray. No one, huh? Very good. You are telling lies, you know, truth. You are saying, telling truth. Most of the time it is not attitude to pray for that fellow, Lord, punish him. But the attitude is here. Solomon is teaching us. That is a renovation. That is a repentance. And if we can see another one, 1 Kings 8:33 to 34. When your people of Israel are defeated by the enemies. So to win the race, to win, to overcome, and he is praying. That is another petition. And we can go to the other one, 8:35 to 36. When you hold back the rain because of your people have sinned. See, there was a tendency, when you are in sin, God is going to stop the rain. And you know, when Elijah prayed, there was no rain for 3 years. And after that, see, the rain has come when he prayed. And that is also it. And 1 Kings 8:37 to 40, another petition. When there is a famine, and the Lord, that time, famine time also, he prayed. And another petition, 8:41 to 43. When a foreigner who lives in a distant land hears of your name. Suppose if I'm not a believer, when he hears of prayer, then we always include him in that. Another one is of your name. And when you command your people, also the 46 to 49, same chapter, into the battle against there. When your people sin against you, when your people sin against you, he is such a wonderful king because he has experienced his kingship. They are not doing well. They are doing all kinds of sin, but he is praying. And even Jesus prayed on the cross, Lord, God, they do not know what they do. They do not know what they do. And that is the reason, that kind of prayer we should have. And when your people sin against you, and another thing, forgive all their sins and their rebellion against, and hear their prayers. And he's praying for all the people. And that is another, the last petition. We can, two more petitions. 1 Kings 68, 62 to 66. Then King Solomon and all the people there, and all the people dedicated the temple. I don't know how many of you have come with the special offerings. And here the king and all the people, they have offered their sacrifices. And you don't know, you know, our blessings also reduced, our offerings also reduced. How many of you know? So when Moses asked people to build the temple and to bring the offerings, there was no place to keep in their storeroom. He said, stop, don't bring. Is any pastor or treasurer will say, stop money, don't bring? No, he says no, very good. Jagannathan Peter, Reverend Jagannathan, you will never say no. Yeah, we all say no. Bring, bring. But here, the time was so blessed. Please stop, there is no place. Offerings. Because our patriarchs, forefathers, were blessed with the clean hearts. And that is what God is expecting. I have, it was a temple which was consecrated by not bishop, not people, by God. Because the word of God says, I have heard your prayer, I will come and consecrate. Dear friends, he may use bishop, he may use your dears, he may use a pastor, other members, but Jesus and the God should say, I am going to consecrate. And here, God is going to consecrate the renovation of the church. That is our belief. I believe that. That is a very, very important thing. The third one is, you are God's temple. See? You are God's temple. What a wonderful. And when we go to the marriages, not only bride and bridegroom will prepare, but we also will go for makeup. You know, because we are attending marriage. And some of them say, all other days they look black, that day they will look very white. You know, the makeup has come like that. They will change the person. When I solemnize marriages, and soon after the marriage I went to visit them, and that girl was white and now she is black. No, Bishop, that was a makeup. So here we say, you are the God's temple. How you are consecrated as it is, as we are. Come before the Lord as we are. Open, God will see your hearts. And that is the reason, once again I am reminding this church, you are the temple of God. The church should grow. I always say, I visited one church after 25 years, only 25 people were there. I felt sad. Church should grow. Congregation should increase. Boundaries. Good, you are trying for the personage. You have renovated. That should be there, you, because Matthew 21:13, what Jesus speaks to us. Jesus said to them, it is written in the scriptures that God said, my temple will be called a house of prayer. You must have this place as a house of prayer. Then only house of blessing will become house of blessing. So house of prayer. And if you turn, when we go to the St. Paul, 2 Corinthians 6, verse 6. I will be their God and they shall be my people. That the same way, they are influenced by the Old Testament. When I am reading this verse of St. Paul, I will be their God and they shall be my people. Have you find this word in Old Testament anywhere? Can any person say? Many times said, one place, at least I recollected my memory. If you turn to the Jeremiah 31:31-34, can anybody read in English or in Tamil? Jeremiah 31:31-34. either in English or Tamil we can read. Is it 31 to 34?
அந்நாட்களுக்கு பிற்பாடு நான் இஸ்ரவேல் குடும்பத்தோடு பண்ணுகிற உடன்படிக்கையாவது நான் என் நியாயப்பிரமாணத்தை அவர்கள் உள்ளத்திலே வைத்து அதை அவர்கள் இருதயத்திலே எழுதி நான் அவர்களுக்கு தேவனாயிருப்பேன் அவர்கள் என் ஜனமாயிருப்பார்கள் என்று கர்த்தர் சொல்லுகிறார்.
So this is what God is, I will put my word in inner part of your hearts. See, sometimes you may like, you may not like. Good morning, Bishop. Inside you may like or you may not like. Hello, na, who you are, na, anna, achcha na. But he will not say outside, anna, anna, anna. So, but here I will put my word inner parts of your heart. The depth of your heart is going to put the word of God. Down the foundation. The foundation is filled with the word of God. Definitely roof will be the same. That is what he says. I will put my word in a part for your heart. And he also says, I will write my word on your heart. He can say, I example, there is a word of God, calendar is there. What word is there? Somebody can read. So there is a word. Word is where it is on the wall. And word where it is in the Bible. But here the new covenant, when he is making an agreement, God is saying, I am going to make a new agreement, new covenant. I will put my words in the depth of your heart. And on your heart I will write. The third one is, then you will become my people and I will become your God. See, St. Paul must have read that. I am hoping, I did not say exactly, it is my understanding. Because they based on the Bible. They read the Bible and the 6:6, I will be their God and they shall be my people. And in the same way, Jeremiah long time back, he said, then you will be my people and I will be your God. That is the reason you are God's temple. I never see how good the wall is. And I see how good our people. How good is our church? I ask how many people, what is their age, how many children are there, how many young people are there, how many old people are there. If you go to the other countries like America and United States of America and England and other places, churches will be very big. People will be only 10 in numbers. Because they are blessed like anything. No one would like to come to the church and worship. And the people, those who are worshiping, above 60. Because anytime I may die, let me close it to God. Other people will not come. But in all ages, people do die. And is he going to be your God? Are you going to be his people? That is what your temple of God. And if you turn to the 1 Corinthians 3:16, surely you know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit lives in you. Surely. And here the St. Paul is telling to the Corinthians, surely you know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit lives in you. And that is what you are a God's When you are a temple of God, the Spirit live, and you know that other spirit we speak about, that as long as Spirit is there in us, we will talk. The moment Spirit is taken away, what happens? People say, die. So most of them crying, I heard, Pastor, mummy is not talking, mummy is not saying anything, mummy is not moving, she didn't say anything. When we hear the prayers, the innocent people, how they cry, because the Spirit is taken. Even when you live, that here, the 1 Corinthians 3:16, surely you know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit lives in you. When you are the temple of God, He should have a Spirit of God. Dear friends, you must know that Spirit of God is not there. The Spirit is there in your heart. You will be totally different people. Your behavior is a total. Your word is different. Your deed is your actions are different. Everything different, because Spirit of the Lord is guiding you. That you all should become temple of God. And 1 Corinthians 6:19 says, don't you know that your body is the temple of God? Holy Spirit who lives in you, who lives in you. Don't you know? God is questioning. And we all answer that question. And that is what God is asking. What is the temple of God? What is the church? And Romans 12:1, then very good answer. There only we can find Romans 12:1. So then, my brothers, offer yourselves as living sacrifices to God. Dedicate His series, we can say, and pleasing to Him. And that is what, you know, we have to dedicate the temple. Sacrifices. Are we sacrificing ourselves to God and pleasing to Him? This is the true worship that you should offer. So three things we have heard this morning. One is the tent of the Lord's presence. And we see the second one, the temple of dedication prayer. 10 petitions I have given. And the last one is, you are the temple of God. And God is only coming and consecrating. That is the reason that even order of worship based on in Methodist Church, you must follow everything. Why we are not changing? Many people may say, change the order of worship. It is completely based on the Bible. And on Bible words will not be changed. And dear friends, this morning, are we looking for the God's presence? And are we looking to the temple of God? And God says, you are the temple of God. And you are the people of God. And He will be your God. And you will be His people. I and you are belongs to God. Let the presence be filled in this temple, in this church. And Jesus' presence be with us in the time of a season. And John 1:14 says, He left heavenly glory. The Word became flesh, dash, and dwelt among us. He became flesh. And that is a Christmas. He became man. Why He became man? In order to make the men, all people, to people of God. So He died on the cross. The Christmas is a season of the hope, love, peace. And that is what, let the peace be in your hearts. Let the presence of God dwell in you. And everything according to the temple will go and have peace in your heart, in your family, in your community, in your children. May the presence of God bless you all. God bless you. Amen.